Hi, and welcome to the first part of the electronic reporting from scratch series, where we are going to include into the equation the word performance. And we are going to do it seeing the difference between the use of the function filter and the function where that we already used in the past. So we are going to correct the electronic reportings that we did in previous videos. If you haven't seen them, I recommend you to see them before. And why it's this important? Like, it's not that important to see the difference between where and filter, but to see how performance is important in electronic reporting. Electronic reporting, despite not being a code-based solution or whatever, we could say it's development. So performance can be very, very important, and it's mainly used for reporting and integration. In both of them, if you are doing a report with thousands of records or even million records, if you are exporting, for example, ledger information, believe me that you are going to need those tools to optimize your electronic reportings. So follow me in this very short video, and let's learn something together. Let's go. So let's talk about optimization of our electronic reporting. For this, we are going to use the electronic reporting created in the previous chapter of this series of electronic reporting from scratch, in which we exported in Excel format the data of our tables, and in that case we are going to analyze the model mapping, because we remember in the export cycle we go from the tables to the through the model mapping we go to the model, and through the format mapping we go to the format. But usually the optimization problems are in the part that are related with the tables. So let's go to the model. This is the model. The model is perfectly fine. It's an empty structure, but the important things are happening here in the model mapping. So let's go to the designer and let's see some things. The problem we are going to see is the abuse or the use of the where function and the alternative filter function, and why I used the where function in the other video if I knew it wasn't optimized. The answer is because of didactic reasons. Why? Because even if it's not optimized, over optimization is also a problem. When you develop, you have to be efficient, and efficient is not only to do your code optimized, but to do your code optimized enough to don't have any problem, but not that much for adding extra complexity. So the where function works really good, and it's very easy to work with it, and blah blah blah. And the filter added some extra problems, so I decided to put it in a split video. But this is not about where versus filter, but this is about the conscientiation of electronic reporting is also development. It's no code development or even low code development, but it's development, and so we need to be aware of that we can do can mess up with the performance if we don't put it into the equation. So here the problem we've got is first of all, I added some dummy lines to our table, just to let you know. Okay, therefore what we are going to focus now is in the start debugging button here. It's a function that allows you to debug the electronic reporting execution, and it's
probably not the best tool you've ever seen, but at least it's good enough for us to see how or to see the difference between the filter function and the word function. So in this case, the word function is going to read from the database, the record lists are going to be read from the database, and after that the word function, what it's going to do, remember this calculated field header is basically using the word function to this record list. It's going to get all those data from the header object, and in memory with a list, search in this list, like apply the filters to the list in memory. So when the list is big enough, it's going to be a performance issue. So yeah, we can first, before showing you the interesting thing, we can get value here, and it adds the value to the already created records, because of course I needed to add the data here in order to like to explicitly see the difference. So let's see what happens when we try to read 10 records of our calculated field header. Look how long it takes. It's loading. Yes. And here you are. This is the only one record, but it needed to look for in the list, to look through all the list, looking for the records that had the ID 01. However, filter, what it does is that it compiles into a direct SQL statement, so it's much faster, but it has other cons. We are going to adapt or fix our electronic reporting model mapping to use filter. The first thing is to, of course, use the filter function instead of the word function. But as I was saying, filter, it's going to be a direct SQL statement, okay? So if we have logic that it's like electronic reporting objects like calculated fields or some kind of different types of joins and things like that, group bytes or things like that that are done in memory, and they are not done at SQL level, it's going to give us this error. That's why I started using where instead of filter, because when I first started with this, I didn't know the advantages of filter, and I didn't know how it was querying directly into SQL, and I got this error many times, and I started using where. But it's good to dig a little bit more, and yeah, at least I can tell you now, and you don't have to face those performance issues. So the problem is that we have a calculated field in the header, and so we are trying to filter in a header, and filter is only knows SQL languages, and the header is using a calculated field that it's not the SQL thing. So we need to, yeah, we are going to save. It doesn't allow us. Okay, it doesn't allow us. So the first thing we need to do is to delete the calculated field. And when we delete it, of course we are going to need this calculated field because we are using it, but we are going to add it later. Now, without the calculated field, we should be able to change the word function for the filter function. Okay, no errors here. And now, once we have our calculated field well optimized, then we can do the other calculated fee. Of course, instead of doing the calculated the lines calculated field using the where, now I hope you knew we were using the filter, because it's basically better in terms of optimization. So yes, we're going to filter this for one, the ones that I think is header ID equals the ID of the header, that it's ID, I think. Yes. Okay, no complainings. Sorry, no complaints here. So probably it'll work. We don't have even to adapt this, because I use the same name for the calculated field lines, and it's under the calculated field header node. So everything should be fine. Let's now debug it, and you are going to freaking out. Sorry, you are going to freak out with the difference. Here we have the same, this is exactly the same thing, but remember the time it took to load the calculated field for the header using the where function. Look how quick it is now with the filter. Yeah, instantaneously. That's perfect, and it works fine, of course. It's getting only that record. And for the calculated field line, we are going to see no difference, because there aren't enough records into the calculated field line, into the FTD line table to see the difference. But yeah, I wanted to point out that electronic reporting still being development, you might do integrations using it, you might do export of a lot of, for example, ledger information with many transactions, and performance is something you might need to take into account. That was the end of the video. I hope you enjoyed this video as much as I did recording and editing and preparing it. This is a shorter video than the others, but let me know in the comments if you like more explained details of how to, or like quick pills like this. Thanks so much. Subscribe if you are not subscribed, because that helps me a little bit to boost my to boost my morale and to keep giving you that content. Thank you.